2021 and the weather has turned sour. Luckily, with the help of Adam, we cleaned the garage out at the end of 2020 and secured a spot for Violet to sit inside. The next task is to paint the radiator supports for the FB. If you notice, we had to cut the driver's side support in order to fit the larger oil cooler. I used the citrus stripper to remove the old paint. It can be used indoors and doesn't give me a headache like other paint strippers. Normally, I would use a spray can and would recommend that method, but the jug makes some satisfying sounds. Now for the installation.
Thank you.
for the video. So what's actually gonna happen, as you'll notice, I actually took the oil cooler back out. I forgot to remove this side bolt here to get this line off. So we have to go to the store and get some type of socket that'll get this off, because I tried with an adjustable wrench, I tried with a regular wrench, this thing does not want to come off. So we're gonna hopefully go get a socket, probably an impact socket, and try to get this bad boy off so we can put our AN lines, then we'll officially mount the oil cooler and officially mount the radiator, and that will be the end of the video. So our good friend Alex is coming over, and we're gonna go to the store and get the tools.
This table's gonna flip.
I know.
Oh, yeah! Woo!
So, that's where we'll leave the FB for now. Baby steps, but the car is getting closer and closer to running. Fuel pump and exhaust have to be figured out, and then the first startup will ensue. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you next episode.
All right, what's up guys? My name is Zach, and we are back working on the 1985 Mazda RX-7. I know it's been a little bit since we've worked on this car, but I'm going to stop apologizing for that because life gets in the way, whatever. I'm gonna get this stuff done when it gets done, and that's the plan. Our goal today is to get it to turn over. That's the goal. I don't know if we'll hit it, but it's always good to aim high. Adam is on his way, he's coming over, the rotary god, we're gonna work on this thing, pluck away, and see what we can do. So, in case anyone was wondering how you conjure a rotary god, you need these three things: sugar cookies, simply blue lemonade or blueberry lemonade, and rotary Hot Wheels. These three things should have Adam knocking on my door.
Howdy ho!
Morning.
You look tired.
Just woke up.
Weekend. Yeah, thanks for coming out.
No problem.
You like my blue turd?
I mean, I've got a red turd.
You got a salmon colored turd.
Yeah, it's pink.
It's pink. Yeah.
It's not exactly where we left. The oil cooler and the radiator's in.
Ooh.
Yeah, look at me. I did stuff.
Look at you.
I think we're probably gonna have to make a run today to get a battery. Oh, well. We definitely need a battery.
Okay.
Fuel pump, we have fuel lines, we have...
I got all the wiring stuff in that truck.
I think we could get it to fire over.
I don't see why not. Just trying to think.
Many things.
So many things, but that's okay.
Alright, well.
So I think for right now, I am trying to find the Red Cars fuel pump because this is our new fuel pump, a Walbro 255, but these fittings are not the proper ones. So we need the fittings from the old fuel pump. Adam, what are you doing?
I am organizing and trying to figure out the wiring.
Yeah, he's doing what he does best, which is organize and wire, which is something I cannot do. I'm terrible at, but all right, we're just gonna pluck away here. What?
He's never tried.
You're right, I've never actually tried wiring, but I know that I would be bad at it. I know that I'd be bad at it, so why even attempt, you know?
What? You mean what, Adam? Say it.
You could just try.
It seems like a lot of work, though.
This is true.
So we are now going to the store to get parts and get some lunch. I know Adam's excited for taps.
Oh yes, very much.
Always excited for taps. I made a list of all the things that we need, which is not that bad. It's not that bad, but we're taking the diesel Colorado and I don't know what Adam's doing, but he's always doing something wild. There's the car. Ready to go? All right, so $334 later, we have a battery, we have oil filter, hose clamps, fuel filter, and a bunch of other things. So we gotta get gas, we gotta get lunch, and then we're back to cracking on the FB. Thanks for the copyright strike.
As soon as I copyright strike your channel.
I tell you what, man. So we just filled up the gas tank with premium, but for the RX-7, of course, but now we gotta secure it. And also, premium here is $4.
Wow.
$4, dude. This was a $20 fill-up for a car that doesn't work yet.
Yet.
Now this is real men of genius.
Hey, I love my ratchet straps at home.
Real men genius. Okay. Also just bought this at O'Reilly's.
Oh.
Adam is literally wiring something unwireable. He's wiring real life. The man can't stop. Is it gonna be strong enough though?
Oh yeah.
What are we working with? 2 gauge here? What is this?
20.
20 gauge?
20.
Wow.
It'll be fine.
Alright. All right, we're full of tacos and burritos. We're on our way back to the FB to try to start it.
Big strong man.
Yeah.
Big strong man.
So now we're back home. I'm gonna work on oil lines. Adam's gonna finish up the fuel pump.
Yeah, fuel pump.
Cool. We're also rocking out hard to Mr. Roboto, but I don't want to get copyrighted. Yeah. So just play it on like your phone and you'll vibe with us. Also, Adam, what did I just give you?
Oh, yes.
Where is it?
More Hot Wheels.
More Hot Wheels.
Black FD. I found it at Walmart.
I don't think I've ever bought a Hot Wheel, but I think I have like 40 of these now because Zach buys me Hot Wheels.
That's my payment to him. I pay him in burritos, blueberry lemonade, Hot Wheels, and sugar cookies.
Yeah, good enough. Good enough.
I mean,
that's more than it's done in like a year and a half.
Oh my god.
You got a bad bushing on that side.
I don't care about a bad bushing.
Yeah, it's just the bushing's bad on that one up there.
Do the lights actually turn on? Holy sh**. Holy sh**.
What?
It's alive!
It does this.
Smoke coming out.
What's up?
Smoke, a little bit of smoke. Yeah.
It's all the
WD-40. Oh, yeah.
Oh. What?
Should I, like, pull the stuff up?
Oh, yeah. It wasn't on it. Never mind. It was just sitting there next to me. Yeah. I just popped it off anyways. Yeah, cool beans.
I'm just waiting for it to catastrophically come to
shot it.
Shot it! Okay.
Or I'll pour gasoline on you.
I'm ready at this point. So we're very close, but we have to go get vacuum hose.
Yeah, vacuum line.
I think I might have accidentally threw it away.
He thinks he did.
I probably. But trip number two to the auto parts store.
$6 a vacuum hose. And a Colorado gasoline-powered peasant. Diesel for life. Diesel boys. You're part of the diesel gang now.
Yes, horse on the diesel gang.
Heck yeah, brother.
We'll be right back.
It fired!
Yep.
The motor still works.
Yeah, it doesn't have an exhaust on it.
Oh, really?
Yeah. All right, cool beans.
I'll let you be loud.
Yeah, you weren't kidding.
Wow, the motor works, huh? Yep. All that time.
All that time spent sitting in the driveway, it still fires over. All right, want to start it? Okay, there's no exhaust on it, so... midsection. Well, that's too high now. Get in here, silly.
Silly, no.
We're done for the night.
For tonight.
For tonight. We did a lot. We did a lot.
Yes. Many things to go.
But many things to go, but it started. Yes. I cannot tell you how excited I am that it started.
How long? Two years? A year and a half?
August of 2019 was the last time that motor fired over.
So a year and a half.
Year and a half.
I mean, mine's set for four, so...
If you're not an RX-7 owner, this is the game that we all play of like, well, my car hasn't been running for this long. Yeah, you're set for four, so mine, a year and a half is the longest I've gone. That's almost as long as it sat with a blown motor. It sat with a blown motor for, about a year and a half.
And so began our relationship.
I know, yeah. Oh, God.
Stay right there.
No.
I gotta pour you a little drink.
Ugh.
Blueberry lemonade.
As usual.
To starting the car. Job well done.
Uh-huh. Job done well enough.
All help. Oh, jeez, I can't even talk. All thanks to you. All help to you.
Kochi sosu on deshita.
I don't know what that means.
It means thank you for the meal.
Oh. Till next time, my friends.
Alright, what's up guys? My name is Zach and we are back again working on the blue RX-7. Now, just a quick reminder of what happened last episode. It runs now. It runs. That was our big hurdle of getting the engine actually to fire over. Now, it's just going to be kind of odds and ends. This is going to be a really super ADHD, all over the place video. We're going to try to do some of the cooling system, get the old exhaust off. It's going to be all over the map. So, Alex is coming over. We might have a couple other people coming over to help. And we're just going to crank away at the car. Like I said, it's going to be kind of all over the place, but progress will be made. So, welcoming home, our 1931 Ford Model A is back in the building, holla. But I do have to move it because then we're gonna swing the RX-7 over to work on the RX-7. So I'm sorry. I have tons of videos of this car on my channel too if you're interested in the 31 Ford. Still the four cylinder from the 30s. It's pretty much all original besides an alternator, a windshield, and a couple other minor things. But yeah, let's pull it out and then we'll get this RX-7 moved over and then we'll start working on it.
Yeah.
Victory.
As you guys think. I am dumb, but just
They never
not...
said you were dumb.
I could feel it.
You're stupid, but you're dumb.
Stop.
You're never gonna make it in NASCAR.
I don't know why they didn't accept my resume.
Calling it a day there. So we got a lot accomplished. First of all, the biggest thing was getting the old exhaust off, which is fully removed, and I have, if anyone wants it and can pick it up in the Chicagoland area, you can have a full 12A 85 RX-7 exhaust, as my dog is going crazy inside. I apologize. We got some coolant lines ran, we bled the brakes, which was huge, and we went to go bleed the clutch, but we need a new clutch master and clutch slave cylinder. They're just really gunked up and not worth putting on the car, so those will be ordered tonight. And I think that's it. The interesting thing about the rear brakes is that there's actually not a bleeder for the rear drums on the driver's side. The bleeder for the rear drum brakes is just on the passenger side, which I found really interesting. Probably makes sense, I assume, because it's the driver's side in Japan for right-hand drive cars. But yeah, so I hope you guys enjoyed. I'm sorry this is sort of a little bit shorter of an episode. I didn't film a whole lot today, but we're just kind of messing around. A bunch of friends came over, so it was really nice. But we got some things done on the car. So the car is moving forward and getting closer and closer to drive every day. I do have a deadline for the car of Father's Day because I am signed up to take the car to a Father's Day car show. So the car has to get moving and driving before that. Oh, and we mounted the header. I totally forgot. We mounted the header. I mounted the header. So yeah. Thank you so much to everyone that came over. Theo, Alex, Adam, and Eddie, all for helping out. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Progress is being made on the blue car, and I love it. So, catch you guys next time. Bye.
Alright, what's up guys? My name is Zach, and today we are working on the RX-7 again, but this episode is going to start off with a couple of errands we have to run. So, I'm in my 2019 Mazda 3 hatchback, all-wheel drive, always got to mention the all-wheel drive, and we're actually driving to Walmart right now to give away the muffler that we pulled off of Violet in the last episode, right here.
Woo! Oh, that's a big one, huh?
Victory.
So I'm meeting up with Israel. He has an FB and he is a follower of the channel, which is really, really cool. So we're going to be giving him the muffler. So I'm meeting him up at Walmart and maybe we'll do some shopping, things like that. But then we will get into working on the blue car, I promise.
This, you got fuel injection is just straight solid.
This car is beautiful though.
Yeah, dude.
It's really clean.
It took me a long time to get it to where I wanted it to be.
I know that game though.
Alright, so now we are back in the garage and I'm just gonna do a little bit of housekeeping before we get cracking on the blue car. So, as you guys saw in the last episode, the footage I'm showing now is from my clutch master. Not good. So, new parts. Finally new parts. I feel like I haven't done an unboxing video for new parts in quite some time. This stuff is from O'Reilly's. The UPS man just dropped it off and he told me he just bought a Datsun, I want to say 720, something like that, which is really, really cool. Same UPS guy we always have. He's really cool. I believe he used to have like an EK Civic or something. So I'm excited to see him getting on the old Japanese car wave as your boy is as well. So we have a clutch soft line. This is part 073-1183 by Beck and Arnley. We have our Power Torque clutch hydraulics. Bada bing and bada boom. This is our slave cylinder that is our master cylinder, I believe. Yep, here's our new slave. So this means this is our new master. Other O'Reilly's pickups, of course, I had to grab more brake clean and hose clamps. Hopefully we should be using those in this video today. And then I picked up this. This is Valvoline VR1 20W50 synthetic oil. This is what I run in my RX-7 and I always get questions of what oil to run. This is what I highly recommend. 20W50, the weight is the most important part, 20W50. Just because rotaries run so hot that when the oil starts to thin out, you don't lose that much viscosity in the oil. A lot of rotary guys, most rotary guys run 20W50, especially if you don't run in a colder climate. I will never drive this car in the snow or anytime below 30 degrees, so thick oil is fine. However, if you do plan on driving your rotary in the snow or below 30 degrees, I would try to find maybe a little bit thinner of an oil, but I still like my 20W50. Last but not least, it's not here yet, but I do have on order tires, but not for the gold wheels. The gold wheels are gonna go away for a little bit. I wanna get them refinished, I wanna get them looking good. So in the meantime, I am going to run the SA Waffle wheels from the 1978 to 1980 RX-7. I've had these wheels for probably about 4 years. I've never done anything with them. I'd like to put them on the car. So I finally got tires ordered for them. When they come in, I'll give you the specs and everything. But one last thing, actually, speaking of the wheels that I totally forgot, is we have to switch out the lug nuts, or lug studs, my bad, because the ones that are currently on the car, I'll show a picture here comparing, are not OEM and they're super short. So I have the OEM ones from Rose. We're gonna swap those on. They're smaller 17 millimeter, where the aftermarket ones are, I believe, 21s. They're just a lot shorter and these wheels are only on by a couple threads. So we're gonna dig those out from Rose, put those on, and we'll be on our merry way.
Also, shout out to Gingium for the table. He gave it to me at his last garage sale, which was super fun. Wishing him the best as he goes down to Georgia. And hopefully maybe one day he'll get another rotary, but this is his table, so shout out to him.
Also, before we get started here, I know the title probably gives it away, but the goal for this video is to do one victory lap of my cul-de-sac. So I live at the end of a cul-de-sac. The plan is to back the car out under its own power
drive it around in a circle once, and pull it back in, all under its own power. I don't know if we'll do that today. I don't know if we'll be able to do it today, but by the end of this video, that's the plan. Video. Alright, so obviously that did not go quite as planned. We got the brakes bled. Well, the brakes were already bled. We bled the clutch. We got the new master slave and soft line in the car for the clutch. We bled it. It still needs a little bit of bleeding, but it was good enough. It was getting into gear and everything. So we decided to roll it out of the garage so we didn't start it up, you know, right next to the wall, you know, catch anything on fire, whatever that would have been, whatever. So we rolled it out into the street, as you saw, and then it didn't start. And it still won't start. It's getting fuel. We know that it's getting fuel. It's getting air, and it's getting spark. We tested the spark. However, the spark plugs were pretty fouled. So I'm going to pick up new spark plugs. But they weren't fouled to the point where it wouldn't make it fire over. We got a couple puffs here and there. It honestly felt like timing was off, sounded like timing was off, but we didn't touch the tune from the last time we started it to this time. We haven't touched the ECU, we haven't touched the tune. The only thing that we did is we bolted on the header and we bolted on the intake, and then now it won't start. So we're going to have to wait for Adam. The car will start and drive by the end of this video. But right now we're just going to take a brief intermission. It was a infuriating night, super frustrating. Because I know the car runs, I know that the engine is good, it's just something was missing, something got knocked off, something was slightly changed to make it not run. But what we do have is something really cool down here. These are Westlake RP18s. Now Westlake's, they're not the top brand of tire, but I did run these tires actually on my Miata and they weren't bad, even in the rain. I actually kind of liked them. And they're super cheap, they're on Amazon. These are going to go on the 13 inch waffle wheels from the SA, and so we're gonna put them on. So now we're gonna go get the rims mounted onto the tires, or tires mounted onto the rims, and then put them on the car. So when we do drive the car, it's going to be a lot more safe than the gold wheels for now, because the gold wheels don't sit properly on the hubs at the moment. We'll get that fixed later, so we're gonna run these for now.
So like I said, these are the 1979 RX-7 wheels, and they have been sandblasted, but that was over 4 years ago. I got these about 4 years ago. These have been like everywhere. They've been in my room, they've been in my old G6. And so we're gonna clean them up and give them a nice fresh coat of paint. I'm using just whatever store-bought paint there is. Gonna do a quick thing of primer and then spray them down, and hopefully we'll get them looking a lot better so we can mount the tires on them and get them on the car.
Why it didn't run. You didn't tell me the power cable committed suicide. You know, the main power feed for like the entire car.
So Adam's been working on this car for maybe 10 minutes?
Yeah.
And we think we know the issue?
Yeah.
He thinks he knows the issue?
Yeah.
It all has to do with the power to the car.
It runs. I just drove it. I teared up a little bit. I'm so happy. I don't even know how to address the camera right now. It's just, after 2 years, I finally drove it. Matt's coming over, Steen's coming over, Adam just did a little bit of tuning as you saw on the car. I really don't have words at the moment. Hopefully I'll address the camera, maybe later, maybe next video, I don't know. I'm just...
never ceases to surprise me.
So I'm switching over to the GoPro because it has way better image stabilization for moving around like this. So we're done with the blue car tonight. Again, I'm so happy. I'm so happy. but Matt's coming over with his new Nissan Gloria, so we're gonna check that out and end the video that way. We're not gonna mount the SA wheels yet, but I've been putting coats of paint on them all day. And so, they look fantastic. Absolutely love these wheels. Super excited to put them on the car, but that's gonna have to wait till next video, because this video is, well, we already did the main thing. So, yeah, now we're just waiting on Matt to get here. This is water, by the way.
Whole gang's here.
Gang, gang.
Gang, gang. What'd you get for dinner? Oh, Culver's.
Oh, I was like,
big Culver's guy.
I literally got out of the car and was like, wait a minute, he's on the wrong side.
I know. We all thought Morgan was driving. Hi.
Hi.
How are you?
Good, how are you?
Good.
How's it going, bud?
Good.
Good.
49.
This thing is pretty clean, huh?
Yeah, quite.
Wow. How do you like it?
I love it.
Yeah.
I'm absolutely in love with this car. Thrilling stuff.
Wow.
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 Yeah, I was able to like pick up some of the stuff.
Can we hold it?
Ow! It's Cedric and Gloria.
Ah, okay.
Cedricu.
Gloria.
Yep. And Gloria.
Gloria.
Yep.
Euro spec, my guy.
Wow.
It's like that Euro M3. Wow.
Nobody has ass.
I love a hard-working man. What'd you say, base model 3 transport?
Transport, YouTuber, fab guy, boss of God, you know.
This is... Ooh.
We forgot to latch down the hood, so we're doing that now at the gas station.
I don't think OSHA approves of this. Leave it to Adrian to not even spill his drink doing this. You haven't even dropped a single drop of water yet.
Well, I kind of like drink a little bit.
Oh, well, still.
We are wet, okay?
Okay. Oh, you spilled some? No! Oh man.
Yo, when you edit this, make sure you put the fucking Benny Hill theme over this.
Oh man.
You
know
let's see him. Wow.
Doesn't get any better.
That's good.
I don't know if I think my head should be in the shot. The diff is already full. Like, with like good like honey colored liquid.
Oh, baby.
Oh, gear oil is the worst.
Isn't it?
But it actually, the diff seems healthy. The trans is not healthy. What was that ball that came out of it?
Detent ball.
A detent ball came out of it, as well as some shrapnel was stuck to the drain plug.
You don't like seeing loose balls in your soup.
You don't want loose balls in your soup. You can quote Asteen 13 on that.
Like and subscribe.
Like and subscribe. It's been a long day, man. It's been a long, long day. Oh, Teflon tape. Look at that. We're getting official.
Yeah, otherwise it'll seep. Go ahead.
You'll seep.
Seep me, daddy.
Tapered threads always require Teflon. Straight threads require washers.
Hey, is this something I should be careful of over-tightening as well?
100%.
Cool. Let's hope I don't over-tighten it, huh?
Grab the ratchet like halfway up. Yeah.
You sound like my Little League coach. He used to always tell me to choke up on the bat.
Exactly. Do that.
Choke me, daddy.
I think that's good. Do you want to check it? Everything I do, Adam checks.
Yeah, that's good.
Yay, Zach did it good. So Adam's putting the final touches on. Basically, we need to make a custom throttle cable bracket for the 13B and the FB chassis using the FB throttle cable, right?
Yeah.
So here it is.
Different lengths.
So, custom bracket. We had one on the red car, no idea where it went.
Was that because it was automatic?
No.
No, it's because it's the FC intake, but it's right, the FB right. Throttle cable with the original throttle. That's the throttle cable for the chassis. So it's a different length.
And I'm just dumb, didn't he?
I explained it in a bad way. Adam explained it in the Adam way, which is the good way. So.
Nah, it's just the pole length's different. So. You gotta move the mounting point.
We're learning.
So now on screen, I'm going to show some phone pictures with some measurements in case you have to make your own. But we're gonna just get a quick little coat of paint on it and call it a day and get the heck out of here. It's been a long, long day. As
it's been that way.
Steen, let's see the hair. Oh man.
Oh baby.
This day has been longer than your hair. For sure.
For sure.
For sure. Sounds like there might be a rotary out here. Oh, look at that! That physically hurt!
I know, it's loud. Way too loud. Last time I had this car, there was a turbo in front of it. Now there's no turbo. It's loud.
So, it has been a very long couple of days. We trailered the car in on Friday night, we worked on it Saturday night, and now it is Sunday morning. I don't know if the dirt under my fingernails will ever come out, but hey, that's what it's like working on a rotary. Speaking of rotaries, RX-7. So, let's talk about it. Let's talk about the negatives that came up. Well, first of all, we discovered that the rear brake is leaking. We think it's the wheel cylinder, so the wheel cylinders have actually been ordered from Atkins Rotary and hopefully should be here this week. Other bad news was the fact that the trans had a little bit of shrapnel in it. Luckily, the drain plug of the transmission is actually magnetic. Most cars do this, and it actually collects that shrapnel, so when we pulled it out, that's what we saw, as well as that ball bearing thing from the trans. I forget what it's called.
Detent ball.
A detent ball. Thank you, Adam. So, the transmission isn't as healthy as I would probably like. Now, is it going to fall out of the car? No. Which it was probably more likely to fall out of Rose than it is with Violet, but It's neither here nor there. Other bad news, there might be some Bondo in the driver's side door. Not a whole lot, but it sort of looked like there might have been a little bit of Bondo, which isn't the end of the world, but it's also not something that I really want to see in my car. But other than that, let's talk about the positives. The exhaust is welded up, thank you to Adrian. It's welded at the header, header to midpipe, and then midpipe to muffler is actually just a clamp because we actually couldn't find flanges. I went to 10 stores yesterday, 10 stores to find flanges, and I could not find them. So we ended up just using clamps. It'll be fine for now. Eventually, I would like to do a full custom exhaust, probably racing beat mufflers with some custom 3-inch stuff, but that'll be a later video. We're just focused on getting the car moving. Other positives is that Adam built a proper throttle cable bracket as he described a couple minutes ago in the video. That was very important and very crucial. So that's going to be it for this video, but I want to talk about the next steps of what's going to happen next with this car. First of all, we were going to mount the new waffle wheels from the SA. However, there's actually an issue that I'll talk about next video where the lug studs from the FB actually aren't long enough for the SA wheels. So I had to order custom lug studs. They're on the way. And again, we'll talk about that next video. If you want to see the tires mounted on the SA wheels, that is currently up on my Instagram at FBZach, if that's something you'd like to see, but I'll talk about it all next episode. Next up, I have to register the car, get it up to date so we can throw a license plate on it and get it all good and dandy, as well as work on that rear wheel cylinder. Again, coming from Atkins Rotary, we're going to do both of them on either side. And so the car is actually going to stay here at Adrian's shop for a little bit in order to get that stuff done. Overall, I'd say it was very, very productive. Thank you so much to Adam and Adrian for all the help, and Steen hung around too. But thank you to both of them. Here is Adrian's Venmo if you want to send him a dollar to say thank you for doing the exhaust and letting the car stay in his shop. He's being very gracious with letting me do that. A little temporary home for Violet, home away from home, so we can get a bunch of this stuff done. Again, always huge thank you to Adam, super knowledgeable, super helpful with the brackets and things like that. And yeah, overall, I'd have to say it's been a very good couple days, very long couple days, very tiring couple days, but that's how it goes with these things. Progress is being made, and I'm so, so excited for it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thank you guys so much for sticking with this series and this car. More to come in the coming days and weeks. I don't know when the next episode will be out, but I will, of course, keep you guys up to date. But I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Don't forget to rate the video, comment on the video, subscribe if you really liked it, and we'll keep this thing a-moving. Take care, guys. So it's 7:50 in the morning. I woke up at 6 to come do this. I'm at the DMV. We're gonna register the RX-7, hopefully. I'm gonna try to get extended antique plates, which means it's a 25-year-old vehicle or older. I can't drive the car between November and March, but they're a lot cheaper. It's an antique vehicle, blah, blah, blah. And the extended antique means that I don't have to record my odometer and I don't have a mileage limit, where the antique plates here in Illinois have like a mileage limit. So let's see how long the DMV takes, because it's not the fastest system we have here in America. God, I swear, going to the DMV is like pulling teeth. But sheesh, we got plates. The RX-7 is registered. It is in my name. Expanded antique, my bad. 1985 Mazda RX-7 coupe. Let's go, baby. Thank you.
hold this nut on the back side of here.
Adam always holds my nut. He's a really good friend.
Yeah. You only need to do the left side first. One at a time. Can't get too excited, all right?
I can't even screw in a license plate. Like, everyone always is in my Instagram DMs. And they're like,
You're perfectly in the corner. That was hilarious.
Everyone's in my Instagram DMs like, how do I do this on an RX-7? I don't know! they talk to me like I'm an expert.
Well, you do have a show on YouTube called Rotary Life.
Yeah, but does Steven Spielberg know how to fight sharks?
Oh, hold on.
No.
He has a movie
You don't know
it.
That?
Dude, what if Steven Spielberg
just... At the beginning of your Rotary Life, you have to put a disclaimer, like, you know, not based on, true story.
Oh, like those medical shows where it's like, this is not in place of actual medical advice.
There you go.
Woo! All right, you filming?
Lit.
All right, so I drove here without a sticker. Is everyone ready? Is everyone ready?
Oh, yeah.
Your boy's legal.
Okay.
Hello, friend. You need hardware.
Yeah.
It's juiced. It's broken.
That's also why your brakes are dragging.
Look at this ridge. That's where the spring was running.
Dick.
See it?
So you can see the spring broke off. It's sitting in the bottom of, like, so if this was on a car, it was sitting in the bottom here, just rubbing along the inside. And it's on the bottom.
This is supposed to go up top of it.
What was that, Adrian?
Drive home with it?
Yes!
No.
Levers that expend it, but these are actually...
Yeah, maybe it's like back in 1931, like his Model A, but...
No, I thought that was a common thing, like, no. You never had brake lines.
Oh.
You never sell them. Or maybe that was for, like, you didn't need brake booster, like, I don't know.
This is the most common thing I see.
Happened, Adam.
45-year-old car. Well, that the car existed before your owners.
Someone's been in here before because apparently they knew this was an issue. The top floor fitting on top and the back was already round. So
that's good.
Now we're gonna go to our good old Nipex here. Not a sponsor, just amazing tools. We'll see if this comes on.
Today on MythBusters.
And there we are.
I didn't like how Tyler was whispering enhance into my ear.
Enhance.
The best players in the world. We'll save your ass.
Your butt.
No. I said ass.
Let's see how bad this is. Now, how can we tell if it's bad?
Well, if there's fluid behind this cap, which there's a whole bunch. Yeah. And they don't move very nice either. So there's a rubber seal on the inside of this. So this is the piston that moves in and out. So there's a rubber seal that's supposed to keep the fluid in here. Well, unfortunately, the fluid's coming out this way. The fluid comes in the back. Took the other cap off. This one moves.
This one does not. And that's not good.
they should both move. So when it's in here, it spreads these shoes apart, kind of like that. So it spreads the shoes apart and hits the drum, and then that's what causes you to stop.
Jesus.
Paint off the backing plate.
Good.
Are we rolling?
Yeah.
We're good?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. The issue with the lug studs, which FBR 7s have lug studs, is that this is the stock one. This is the one that we had on the car. And then this is the one that I just ordered. So you can obviously see... technical difficulties. So this is the old one. These are the new ones. Obviously, they're a lot longer, so they should hold the wheels on. Ideally, that's the hope. That's the goal. This... is you, this is the guy she tells you not to worry about, and this is me. So, what's up? So tonight was kind of a loss. Basically what happened is the rear brake hardware is all shot. The shoes, the drums, everything is shot. So unfortunately, we can't take the car home tonight, which I'm really, really bummed out about, unfortunately, because also I leave town for 2 weeks in a couple of days, so I won't be able to work on the car for at least 2 weeks, which is sad and depressing, but we are going to get the right parts for the rear drums, fit the rear drums, and hopefully this car is good to go. The wheels are on. I think the wheels look killer. I think they look absolutely awesome. I'm super happy with them. And those wheels are not going to be permanent on the car. They are just an intermediary wheel. They are 1979 RX-7 wheels, so the SA. So we're not going to keep the wheels on there permanently. They are just so I can refinish the gold ones and make them look good and pretty and stuff, and then get good tires for them, and they'll go back on the car eventually. Those are 15s, these are 13s, blah, blah, blah. So it's sad, it's a depressing night. We didn't get a whole lot done. However, it's okay. It is what it is. The car's registered in my name. The car is legally insured, which is fantastic. That is a huge weight off my shoulders. And we'll find the brake parts. We'll get it going. And that's it. So I guess I'll see you guys. Well, for you, it'll be this next clip. But I'll see this car again in a little over 2 weeks. So don't miss me too much. So, it has been 3 weeks since we last worked on the RX-7, and today's inspiration is coming from this. This is the placard for my RX-7 for the Father's Day car show, which was this morning, and the car did not make it there. Obviously, we still have the braking issue, but since the last time I saw the car, I have driven across the country, and I am now back, and I have made up my mind on what we're going to do. Instead of fixing the drum brakes and trying to source all the parts, a lot of which are NLA, we're just going to finally do the disc swap into the rear end of Violet. So, if you guys remember, my old red RX-7 had rear disc brakes as well as a limited slip differential, and first gen RX-7s have a solid rear axle. I kept that rear axle from the red car in hopes of one day putting the disc brakes onto the back of the blue car, which has drums currently, which you just saw are not in good shape. Adam is coming over with his pickup truck. We are going to grab the rear axle. We are going to bring it over to the shop, and that's probably all that we're going to do today. We might paint it. We might look at it, some things like that. But the actual installation of the solid rear axle will be in the next video, because I want to get this video out to you guys and update you guys. And I also didn't want to leave you on such a depressing note
like I just did. If I would have ended the video there, it would have been kind of sad. So you are still going to see some progress, and you're going to know our game plan moving into next video. So we got to clear some space in the garage, get the rear end out, and toss it in the truck. That's where I'm gonna leave it today. We're gonna finish the rear end in the next video. It's very dirty, as you can tell, as I'm looking at myself in the viewfinder. But to end out the video, we will be doing the rear end in the next video. You can hear right now, Adam is putting together the exhaust on his FC. That's what he's been doing this entire time while I was working on the rear end. So we'll start it up. I'll end the video with some rotary noises. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you guys next episode. We'll be putting the rear end into the car.
can actually talk right now.
It's not that bad.
This is nice.
It's conversational volume. All right. Like 50-ish decibels.
We have a heat advisory from LaSalle County all the way over to LaPorte County, all along the I-80 corridor and southward. That is where you could see...
Today is August 24th, 2021. It's getting to be the end of the summer, and in a couple of days here, I turn 24 years old. I started this journey into rotary cars nearly 6 years ago. At the ripe age of 18. And at that time, I didn't really know what I was getting myself into. And now, 6 years later, I still don't know what to expect. But, like I said, it's the end of summer, and I'm tired of my car sitting in a back lot. The good news is, I'm here, and hopefully, I'll be joined by some friends to help put the car together and put the rear end in. The bad thing is that it is a record heat wave here in Illinois. It's about 93 degrees right now. That feels like 106. I don't know what's gonna happen today. I really genuinely don't. But there's only one thing to do, which is put my head down and cue the music.
One issue we ran into was that we only had one slide pin for the rear calipers of the RX-7. Not sure what happened to it, but we only had one. So Adam came up with a genius idea to cut down a Miata slide pin from an NA Miata caliper. It has the same thread pitch, but it's a little bit too long. So I took it to the bandsaw, cut it down to size, and Adam rounded the edges. This is what we made, and this is the original. Spot the differences.
What was that?
Rubber line?
Pop the line.
Jesus. Holy s***.
I was worried that was going to happen.
Are you okay? Did it hit you? Okay.
Worked though. Warning. Heat plus old brake lines may cause explosion. That's hilarious. Last resort. Don't do this. Once it really came out, I boiled the brake fluid inside. So I boiled the fluid inside of the line and it popped. I mean, you're doing a brake fluid flush anyways, and these lines are getting replaced, so it's not a huge deal. That's why if you want to keep the lines, you don't need heat.
Yeah.
But since we weren't keeping any of the lines, we can use heat.
How are you feeling, Zach?
Scared.
Yeah? So would you like to tell YouTube what's going on?
Everything's perfect, except now the alternator decides it doesn't want to alternate.
But brakes are good, rear end's in. Is this gonna be the same video as the rear end? Bet. Yeah.
Yeah, it runs nice when it's got full voltage.
Should I test drive it or no?
What?
Should I test drive it or no?
Yeah, you'll be fine, just don't stall it. I'm gonna put this in the trap.
Thanks. So it is August 27th now, and I figured I'd take this time to address the camera. I know a lot just happened without a whole lot of explanation. So basically, the rear end of the car is in huge, humongous, statewide, worldwide thank you to Andrew Steen. You guys know and love him on the channel. He was absolutely incredible with helping me get everything together. I cannot thank him enough. But the rear end's in the car. The brakes are in the car. They're bled. They work. The disc rear end works, minus the parking brake. The parking brake cable is different between a drum rear end and a disc rear end. And I do have the parts, theoretically. However, one of them is broken, and we'll tackle that in another video. I can just park it in gear. I'm not really worried about that at the moment, but it will get addressed at some point. But as you saw last night, we're all set to bring the car home. That's the goal. That's the end point of this video. And the alternator stopped working. It probably honestly stopped working a while ago, but it doesn't work, and it tampered our drive home.
meaning I couldn't bring it home, the headlights were getting too dim, things like that. But as you saw, I drove the car. I got into third gear, which that car hasn't been in third gear since at least 2014, which is super exciting. So now our good friend Alex hopefully has an extra alternator sitting around. So him and I are going to go out to the shop tonight, throw the alternator in, and hopefully drive it home. That's the plan. So I'm sorry, this is a very ADHD, all over the place sort of video. But before we get on to the alternator, I do want to give a huge thank you also to Super Clean. Not only are their hats super good at keeping my hair out of my face while working on the car, but they do incredible work with degreasers. Here's me cleaning the floor mats for my Mazda 3. Absolutely fantastic products. I do want to give them a huge shout out. They've been supporting the build for quite some time, and they're absolutely awesome. So go check them out. The link is in the description below if you want to pick up some Super Clean products. I genuinely used Super Clean products before they came on board as a sponsor, but now that they're a sponsor, it's so much cooler now. So anyway, enough rambling for this part of the video. Let's go get that FB.
Hi guys, welcome back to Zach's a friggin' moron. Look at that. Adam labeled alternator. What a guy.
How nice is that? He didn't have to do that. But he freaking
did. This guy right here. This guy.
The heavy use of pry bars. You're doing great.
The things you don't see on YouTube is the heavy disrespect for surroundings.
Look at a man handling that. It's a boy!
Something like that.
There's that good old paint.
Look at that.
Ooh, it's an Eclipse.
It is. I hope it's a GSX.
First fill up.
So I did pre-mix, I don't know how much to put in.
So guys, the RX-7 is home. That was the goal for this video. So we're gonna cut it here. It's a special day. Not only was that an hour-long drive in the RX-7, the first time it's really driven on public roads in 7 years at least, but also the day that you're seeing this video, I am turning 24. So it's a bittersweet moment. I'm getting older. Today, the August 28th, is actually my birthday, the day that you're seeing this. It's a whirlwind of emotions. I don't even know what to say right now besides thank you to everyone that made it possible. Steen for helping get the rear end in and the brakes. Alex for getting me back home and helping put the new alternator in today.
Adam for his just knowledge, Adrian for letting me keep it at his shop. Thank you to all of them. Rod for getting it out to the shop. The list goes on and on. I'm tired, I'm beat, I'm emotionally spent. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. More RX-7 content to come. It's back home, it's running, it's driving. We have to address a huge oil leak, and we have to do something about the parking brake because my driveway is too steep to just park it in gear, so we had to chalk the wheels. That's a whole thing, but that'll be in future episodes. Enjoy this episode. I'm gonna go inside and sleep, and thank you everyone. Here's a slideshow, by the way. My good friend Alex took some pictures on the way home, so here's a slideshow of pictures, and I'll catch you next episode. Take care.
Alright, what's up guys? My name is Zach and the RX-7 is in the garage. We are working on the 85 RX-7 again, but the reason I'm smiling like an idiot is because today is September 1st and it was really, really hot today, but it started to cool down, and having an FB RX-7 to work on in the garage in the fall is starting to start. Starting to get cooler at night, and it just brings me back to when I bought my first car, which was September 20th, 2015. So really, really feeling those throwback memories right now, which is just the coolest thing in the world, and I have yet another RX-7 to work on in the fall. But today's video, we have a couple of tasks to take down. First of all, as you can see, maybe right there, there's a very ugly red line for the vacuum that comes off the master cylinder. We're gonna swap that out. We have to do some oil cooler work. That's the main goal of this video, is that the oil cooler is draining oil almost as fast as we can fill it up. It's really, really bad. We think it's the bolts or the crush washers. We're not quite sure, but that is the main goal today, is to fix the oil leak because it is not good. We had to add oil driving it home from the last video. And just to clarify, or just to fill you guys in, we drove the car home in the last video, and then the next morning I drove it to brunch with our good friend Alex. He brought his RX-7, here's some pictures. It was a super great time, car's driving great. And then later the next week, Tuesday, Matthew came down from Wisconsin to buy my Weds Autobahns. Yes, the gold wheels are gone. I've decided to go a different route with this car, so I did get rid of the gold wheels. I know I said that they were gonna go back on. I'm sorry I lied. I didn't lie, I just changed my mind. But he brought his FB, so I actually drove that. It was a carbureted 13B car, which was really interesting, really responsive, and I actually really enjoyed it. But yeah, so there are some pictures from that. But oil leak, couple little tidy things. Not gonna be a monumental video, but definitely just some cleanup and just enjoy some fall FB RX-7 vibes because, man, it's been almost 6 years of doing this. I love it more every day.
However, this car, I would say, is officially an Illinois resident driving on Illinois roads, so these Texas stickers have gotta go.
So one thing that's a common problem on first-gen RX-7s is these doors get really, really noisy and somewhat hard to close as they get older. My red car had this issue, and now the blue car has the issue. So all you need to do is just apply white lithium grease to the door fitting, as you are seeing here. And here's the before. And here's the after. If your first-gen RX-7 is doing that, just apply some white lithium grease to the actual hinge inside the door and it'll go right away, make the door close so much better. Like I said, I did this with my red car, and I actually did like an advertisement way back in the day. So this is a Rotary Life throwback to owning the red car.
Does this ever happen to you?
Hi, Infomercial Zach here, and boy do I have a product for you. It's called White Lithium Grease. You just lather that baby right on that hinge, but boom! There, you're done. You don't have to worry about it. And there it is. You can pick it up at any local store. You can put it on your dog. You can put it on your little brother. It'll shut him right up. I don't know. I don't care what you do with it. Put it on your first gen doors.
Identified the leak thanks to Alex and Brendan stopped by as well. We identified the leak as the drain plug was not fully tightened on the oil cooler. Rookie mistake, I know, but we put everything back together and then I was looking on the ground and I was like, what is this? So the Turbo 2 oil cooler, and actually all FC oil coolers, have a thermostat inside of them. I was unaware of it. This is what it looks like, and so I forgot to put it back in. Friends have now left. It's almost 9 o'clock. I gotta run out. I'm gonna go grab an oil filter and just do an oil change on the car. Might as well. While I'm doing that, I'll take the drain plug out and put the thermostat back into the oil cooler. So it's unfortunate. I thought I was done for the night, but that's just how RX-7s go. It's a nice night outside. Temperature's great. I'm just gonna go run and get an oil filter, do an oil change, and put it back all together. So always something fun with a rotary.
So, the rest of this video is going to be a little bit all over the place. So, grab a drink. If you've made it this far in the video, please leave a comment of just what's in your cup. No other context, just what's in your cup if you're drinking tonight as well. And I salute you for sticking with my ADHD ways. So, the car was having a little bit of trouble after we fixed the oil leak. At about 5,000 to 5,500 RPM, the car started to cut out, started to lean out according to the AFR, which is not good at all. On top of this, the fuel pump was really, really loud, and it was getting louder and louder and louder. So I took the car back to Adrian's shop for Adam to take a look at.
It was $7.
You get from AutoZone, yeah. As soon as he said it, I was like, just get like 2 pushlock fittings and get an Amazon filter. That's what I'm running on my car. Why are you recording?
If we really wanted a fuel filter, we could just go to O'Reilly's and just grab a random fuel injection fuel filter.
I think, you know what? They have that fucking, they have that boomer.
Ford Ranger. I think I used a Ford Ranger one on the last FB that
No, but I don't know. Right, if you go to O'Reilly's, they have this wall.
Yeah, it's that, the boomer wall.
It's the boomer wall. Ain't nothing tuner about it. It's fucking car shit. Wall.
It's the boomer wall. It's all the Edelbrock and...
Yeah, it's a bunch of Edelbrock shit, fucking heat ramp, the spark plug wires, high performance MSD spark plug wires. I always wondered why the fuck O'Reilly's had that.
I don't have a mustache anymore, which is pretty sweet.
so could have fooled me.
Kept the beard.
Nah.
Should have kept the beard.
No, the beard, his beard is too patchy.
Nah.
I can't grow a beard. That's the thing.
The beard looked great.
No, it didn't look good. Zach, it didn't look good.
Zach with his beard unironically looked like one of those like Cheeto eating fucks that like shit posts on like Facebook and shit.
He still does that anyways.
I know, but like you don't want to let
this is an
know.
Angle, I tell you what.
Ooh, baby.
You don't want to let people know that that's who you are. Like with this, a dude walks up to me, right? That's probably why the guy didn't call him to interview the McLaren that we saw at the Metro. You know, the guy, he rolled up, he's like, who is this dude? This guy looks like he lives in his mom's basement.
What?
No.
What's up?
Kind of glad we put the fuel filter in here.
Is it full?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
All right, is it clogged?
Well, yeah, it's full.
Possibility.
It's probably.
You're gonna have to get down here and look at it, but just look up.
Is that?
It looks like a
zoom
coffee.
In, zoom in, zoom in.
I can't zoom at all.
It what the like, fuck kind of camera?
It's not a zoom camera.
Oh my god. It you looks got like scammed.
A cappuccino.
You just got scammed, bro.
Spicy milk.
It literally looks like Thai.
Good soup. Adam, hold on. Rev it up and then you get to say it.
My name's Adam, not Jason.
He doesn't have instrument cluster lights.
Oh, so you're gonna fix that?
Trying.
After that was all buttoned up, the car drove phenomenally. You should have seen the smile on my face when I took it out. And so, the car was home free. Another thing that Adam did was he fixed the gauge cluster lights. The cluster was not lighting up and it was actually a bad dimmer switch inside the car. So we kind of jumped the dimmer switch and I have gauge cluster lights again. However, we did not rehook up the speedo cable, so I no longer have a speedometer or odometer, but that'll get fixed soon, probably in another video. So I got the car home and I was loving it. I was driving it like a normal car again. And as you can see, I started to clean out the garage with the help of my dad so we could fit both the Model A and the RX-7 in the garage for safekeeping. And while searching through the garage, I found I have four different first generation Mazda RX-7 spare tires, which is great. But I wanted to see if maybe I could consolidate some space and put one of these good spare tires into the trunk of my car. I didn't even know if my car came with a spare tire. I had never even peeled up the rear carpet. And so I went to go do so. Thank you. that's where the rear hatch is remaining right now. The actual wheel well is bedlined. It actually solidified this time. I had really bad luck with bedliner in the past, but it actually seemed to work here on the spare tire well. And so I do need to do a little bit more peeling, a little bit more fixing back there. But for now, at least if it does leak back there, it won't continue any rust. Now, of course, putting the bedliner back there is just band-aiding a bigger issue of where the water is coming from. I blew out the rear drainage channels in the rear hatch, so that should hopefully help. But if it still collects water, that'll be a different story. However, it's now in the garage, so I'm not sure if I'll ever test my theory. Then that night, after I discovered the spare tire, I actually went out and did a photo shoot with my good friend Max Evans. He's absolutely awesome. We did some shots of not only my car, but my good friend David's rotary swapped Corolla. It's a 12A Bridgeport rotary engine. I actually did a review of it earlier this year, so go check out that video if you're interested in that car, which is an absolutely cool car. And then I took it out another night. I went out with my good friend Alex. We recreated some photos that I took with my Miata about a year ago this time. There was even a kid in a Kia Forte GT that was like super impressed with our RX-7s, and so we hit some back roads with him. This thing is shooting fire out the back. Absolutely love that. Then even today, I took it to go do my reviews today, as well as I filmed a video with a 858-mile first-generation Mazda RX-7. That's what you're seeing on screen right now, and that video is actually already up on the channel. You can also go check that out right now as well. Car did phenomenal today, drove great. Everything's been going good. And so that's where I'm going to leave you guys with an update. This is starting to become the boring part of rotary life because the car runs. It's good. It's fun. Now, there's definitely still work to do. The front suspension needs addressing really bad. The rear suspension needs addressing, but that'll probably be a more winter project. There is a clunk up front here. I don't know if you can hear that. The pitman arm is bad. The bushing is pretty much gone. So that needs to be addressed, and that'll probably be in a future video. I want to try to stick a GoPro in there and actually get footage of it sort of rattling around and things like that. But as we're now in October here, I'm going to be doing a lot of traveling for work. I have a lot of work-related travel I have to do, but that's going to result in tons of really cool JDM content. Which I'm super excited about. So if you're into JDM cars, Japanese cars, tons of cool reviews are coming on the channel, which is super, super exciting. But that means that the car is just gonna kind of exist for a little bit. It's great. So please still keep an eye on the channel. I'm gonna be putting out a better version of the video you're about to see. I'm gonna close out the video with some sounds, but my microphone wasn't recording properly, so I'm gonna remake that and make it its own standalone video. And maybe some little how-tos or whatever, first-gen RX-7 stuff I can think of with this. But yeah, that's it for now. Thank you guys so much for your continued support. It's been a blast having this car back. It really feels like the red car. It feels like Rose, just with a different paint job, which is really, really cool. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you have any questions, comments, or concerns about anything that happened in the last couple of minutes, please leave it in the comment section down below. Take care, guys. Unfortunately, it's that time of year where the RX-7 has to go into its slumber. Here in Chicago, it starts to get really, really cold for a couple of months here, mainly from November till about April is not really driving season for these cars. But now with the blue car, because I have it registered differently than I did with my red FB RX-7, I actually can't drive it between the months of November to April. And that's because of that antique license plate down there. It's actually registered as an extended antique vehicle, which the extended portion means that I don't have to record my odometer. I can drive it as much as I want between the months of April and November. So April 1st, April Fool's Day, I can get the car out again and fully enjoy it on the roads. Now, there are some caveats to that law, and it says that you can still drive the vehicle to shows, or you can drive it to the mechanic workshop, or drive it to storage, like we're going to be doing with the Model A here soon. That actually will go away to storage, but this just stays here in the garage, so it's not that big of a deal. And if I do take it out and I somehow, for some reason, get pulled over, I'm taking it to storage. You know what I mean? So it would be fine, but at the end of the day, it's getting cold here, and it's time to finally put the car away. And so I've had an absolute blast with the car this year. I'm still a little timid with it. I still don't drive it too far. I still don't have full trust in it, but it's well on its way. With that being said, we have just the future to look forward to. There's obviously things that I have on my list that I want to address. First of all, being suspension. The suspension is 35 years old, and it could use some work. But besides that, the actual front suspension, the pitman arm bushing, has been making a horrible clunking noise all summer long. Yeah, not great. That's actually some GoPro footage from under the hood. So suspension is going to be our biggest tackle in 2022. Do I want to do coilovers? Do I just want to do lowering springs with new struts? I don't know yet. It's all going to be coming down to pricing and what I want to do with the car and things like that. So definitely stay tuned. And if you have any ideas or experience with that, please let me know. I'm leaning more towards coilovers at the moment, but that is a hefty investment of about $2,500. The other thing that I want to do is finish the interior. The door cards were never put back on. I want to do a radio in the car to actually have some music, even if that is only through two speakers or four speakers or however many are still working, and probably actually upgrade the speakers as well, and refinish the steering wheel. Now that might actually happen over the winter, but I'll update you guys whenever that does happen. I want to either wrap it in new leather or Alcantara, and that's it. So interior and suspension is going to be the focus of 2022. I can't thank you guys enough for supporting this build, supporting me over the years. We're going to be entering season 7, which the season number coincides with the years I've been doing this. So 7th year of working on rotaries. I don't know if that's a blessing or a curse, but thank you guys so much for supporting me for that long. Cars like this really started my YouTube channel and gave me a platform, and I have no one but you guys to thank for that. So thank you guys for a great season 6. The car is running, it's driving, and I can't be happier. But on to bigger and better things. Take care, guys.